Do you have time for a quickie? Okay, so let's make a clock using shape layers. I'm gonna right click in this area to the left of our timeline and choose new shape layer. And then we're gonna rename this clock. So open that up and we wanna add in a group. Rename that to outer rim. Within outer rim, we wanna add in an ellipse and give that ellipse a stroke. Open up these settings and just increase our ellipse path size. Also our stroke width. Go back to our contents and add in another group. We wanna call this hash marks. So within this group, we want to add in a rectangle. We're gonna add in a fill, and we wanna add in a repeater. So we'll take these one at a time. First, let's change the color of our fill. We'll make that white. Now let's unconstrain our size settings. Let's make a little bit of a hash mark, add some roundness. And now let's open up our repeater. We want these hash marks to go in a circular pattern around the inside of our rim. And the trick to doing that lies within our rotation within the transform properties of the repeater. So let's Option Alt click on rotation and type in 360 divided by, and then we want to take our expression pick whip, which is right here, and go up to copies. We also need to change our position 0, 0. And now if we move our rectangle path up, we see we have this circular kind of pattern. The reason why I want to do this expression is because now I can change the number of copies and maintain that circular pattern. So I want to change this 3 to 12. And notice if you change this to anything, it will always stay in that circular pattern. So I'm going to leave this at 12, move this up. And I'm just going to kind of tweak the way everything is looking here. Maybe open up our outer rim, make that a little bit thinner. Go back to our contents. I'm going to add in another group. I'm going to call this center for our centerpiece, and this is just gonna be a simple ellipse with a fill. I'm gonna change that fill to white and reduce the size of it 30. Close that up, go back to contents and add in another group. We're gonna call this long arm. Within the long arm group, we wanna add in a rectangle and a fill. So open up these settings, I'm gonna change our fill to white, unconstrain our rectangle path size settings, so we can make something like this. We'll make this length 260 and maybe make the width, we'll say 20, add some roundness to it. Now we need to move our Y position of our long arm up half the value of the Y value of our size. What I mean by that is this, our size Y value is 260. So let's move the position up negative 130. Now, if you open up your transform properties, as you start to rotate it, you'll see that it's going to rotate from the center. So again, the way I got that was whatever your Y value of your size is, move the position up half the actual value. So 130 is half of 260. Let's close that group up and let's just go ahead and duplicate long arm and we'll call this short arm. Open up those settings. Let's make our size on the short arm, we'll say 200, which means we have to change our position to negative 100. Okay, now we wanna make this thing move. So let's open up our long arm. So Option Alt click on rotation, time times 250. And if we watch that playback, we can just see we just have some speed on our long arm. So since there are 12 hours in a clock like this, our short arm is gonna move 1/12 the speed. Go to our group settings for short arm, open up our rotation. Okay, let me move this up so you can see it a little bit better. So we're gonna take the rotation of our short arm and pick whip down to the rotation of our long arm. And then we're gonna open this expression up and we want to divide that by 12. So now if we watch it play back, we can see as our long arm moves, the short arm is gonna be moving at 1/12 the speed. And the good thing about having this expression is now you can change the speed of the long arm to whatever you'd like and the short arm will always move at 1/12 the speed. So let's make this time times 500. Watch that playback, and we see that our short arm is moving at 1/12 the speed.